Well, Police Chief Bry Layrisson brought good news here to the Ponchatoula Kiwanis, namely that this may have been the safest strawberry festival we have ever had, just two arrests.
It definitely was, Ken, definitely the safest under my watch, and it's a testament to all our neighboring agencies that come out and help us.
On the other hand, you know, we heard the crowd Friday broke a record, so the increased safety had nothing to do with the smaller crowd.
Now, we had great crowds Thursday night. Friday, as you know, was the largest Friday ever. A little bit of rain Saturday, but then a beautiful day Sunday. So all of our nonprofits should have made a good bit of money to help with the great causes that they do in our community.
Well, from your standpoint, what did we learn from this Strawberry Festival?
We learned that it's a great family-oriented event. We had a great crowd that came. There weren't any fights, weren't any trouble. As I've said in the past, officer presence is the key. We try to put an officer on every corner, and I think that helps to deter a lot of the trouble.
Are we learning anything about crowd control or traffic control for years to come?
We learn a little bit every year about both, Ken. You know, traffic control is just a problem. We're such a small community, and there's a couple hundred thousand people come into that 5-10 square block area. So we just try to make little improvements each year.
And there's no reason to believe we won't have some big festivals in years to come, weather permitting.
We're definitely going to keep having successful festivals. Everybody loves to come out and support our farmers.
Well, in the meantime, what are you seeing as far as crime here in Ponchatoula?
Crime's been very low, Ken. We've been blessed. A few minor thefts, minor criminal danger, but no violent crimes to report.
Yet you had a fellow here talking about sex trafficking. We don't think of that as a problem for our young people in our area, but the statistics would disagree, sadly.
We definitely do, Ken. With I-12 and I-55 in our neighborhood, in our area, we have those victims being trafficked through our community on a regular basis.
And how do we know what our kids are doing on social media? We think we know, but no one can be 100%.
We don't. Only the parents can help us in monitoring their children on social media, to put limits on what they can have access to. You know, that's the parents' responsibility.
What else are you working on?
We're getting ready to wrap up another school year. We've had to put a lot of resources in our schools this year to keep our schools safe. We're proud to do that. We haven't had any major incidents at our schools, and we'll keep working to expand that program.
Well, I know that over the summer, the school board wants to do some planning to beef up security. Any ideas?
I think we're going to always be looking at improving the security on all our campuses. You know, unfortunately, we're having school shootings throughout our nation. So we're going to work with the school board, with all of our partners, to make sure our kids are safe while they're at school.